Hi! In order to be able to check the voltage in a car, we need a tester. Making this tester is very simple. To make, we need two resistors, two LEDs, a buzzer, and a diode bridge. I will try the circuit first, and then explain the circuit according to the schematic. I connect the input voltage. This voltage is from the car battery. That is, these two wires are connected to the positive and negative voltage of the battery. There is no difference between positive and negative pole connection. Now, connect this probe to any wire inside the car. If the voltage is positive, one of the LEDs will light up and the buzzer will beep. If this probe is connected to the negative wire, the second LED will light up and the buzzer will beep again. Positive voltage, negative voltage. In both cases, one of the LEDs is lit and the buzzer sounds. Well, now I will check the circuit according to the schematic. I want to introduce the sponsor of the video, PCBWay.com. Everything that is in your mind becomes a reality here. Order it to be made and enjoy. Well, let's go back to the video. We need two resistors. 470 ohm or 330 ohm is suitable. Higher wattage is better. These two resistors are connected to the car's battery. So, at the common end of these two resistors, considering that they have the same value, we will have a voltage of about 6 volts. This is a resistive division. But when they are connected to the circuit, we have a different voltage. Now, we need two LEDs. The working voltage of LEDs must be the same. Connect the anode pole of one of the LEDs to common end of the resistors. The second LED cathode should be connected to the common end of the resistors. So, these two LEDs are connected opposite to each other. We connect the second side of the LEDs to each other. Now, we need a probe to be able to select different wires in the car. We can also use a multimeter probe. So far the circuit is ready, but we need a diode bridge to connect the buzzer. We can use any type of diode bridge. We can even make a diode bridge. The inputs of the diode bridge must be connected to both sides of the LED. It doesn't matter which LED we choose. I connect the diode bridge to the upper LED. Diode bridge has positive and negative output. Also, the buzzer has a positive and negative input. So, we connect the positive of the diode bridge to the positive input pin of the buzzer. The negative output of the diode bridge is also connected to the negative input pin of the buzzer. The buzzer voltage is better to be 3 volts, but I use a 5 volt buzzer here. Now, the circuit is complete. By connecting the probe to the wires of the car, one of the LED will light up and the buzzer will be activated. But how does the circuit work? The upper LED has a positive voltage at the anode because the output of resistors has positive voltage. When we connect the probe to the negative wire of the car, the cathode of the LED also gets a negative voltage and the LED turns on. The same voltage is rectified through the diode bridge and reaches the buzzer. So, the buzzer also produces sound. Meanwhile, the negative voltage has reached the anode of the second LED, and because the direction of the LED is opposite, the second LED does not light up. When there is a positive voltage in the LED cathode, how does the lower LED light up? When the probe is connected to a wire in the car that has a voltage of 12 volts, the anode of the LED will receive a voltage of 12 volts, while the cathode will receive a lower voltage. The potential difference between the anode and the cathode will cause the LED to turn on. If this voltage is the opposite, the LED will not turn on. Thank you for your time to watch this video.